Hello, this is the first voiced video on this channel, let's see if it is a good format. Anyway, I have been using mainly Linux for over a year now. I consider myself more of a casual user maybe. I want to have a usable system with fairly recent programs running fine. I still haven't found the perfect distro for myself. I have switched between them considerably. Recently, a particular distro sparked my interest and I decided to try it out. It is Tuxedo OS. Here are some thoughts I have about it right now in its current state. First, let's take a look at what the distro is about. Tuxedo OS is a Linux distribution by Tuxedo Computers, a German company based in Augsburg that builds fully Linux-compatible computers. The distro is primarily meant for own computers, but works just like your average Linux distro on others. It's similar to System 76 and their Pop OS in that sense. Tuxedo OS promises an updated KDE Plasma desktop environment on top of a stable Ubuntu LTS base. They also provide their own repos with some updated system software, such as the kernel, and they include some tools on their own. The distro is based on KDE Neon, which is built on Ubuntu, which in turn is based on Debian. That's the fourth layer already. Opening up the installer, it is in German by default, not English or anything like a normal distro. As usual, language is the first thing you can change. Something I haven't seen elsewhere is that you're explicitly asked which display manager you'd like to use. Usually you can only set it at the corner of the login screen, with not much mention of it otherwise. Then it just puts you in the live environment. Some of the recordings are from the demo. Anyways, from here you can try out the system in that state or open the installer. The installer first asks you the exact same questions again, but otherwise it is another implementation of Calamari's installer. Let's first take a look at the programs. Tuxedo OS is based on the long-term support edition of Ubuntu, which is released once every 2 years. They get some security updates, but there are only few program updates in between releases, so software may be outdated. Tuxedo OS has yet to transition to the latest Ubuntu edition, released this spring, meaning that distro is still stuck on an over 2-year-old system for a while. It aims to somewhat get around this. Firstly, it brings over the updated Plasma environment from KDE Neon. Basically, you get fresh versions of applications made by the KDE community, like apps related to the KDE Plasma desktop. Being a computer manufacturer, Tuxedo adds some tweaks to their operating system through their own repositories, containing updates to some essential system software. That's all nice, but that still leaves all the other stuff on the old Ubuntu base. Tuxedo promises some testing on their own, so the updates should be a bit more reliable. The distro by default is completely free of Snap, a controversial package formed by Ubuntu. For programs that are for snaps on Ubuntu, a native Debian format is provided, so you don't have to worry about snaps. You also shouldn't have programs secretly setting up Snap if you don't use a format. I know I didn't. If you do use snaps, you can still simply install it. It's indeed available, but not in a way normally. I think this is a welcome change. Tuxedo has its own software repositories for some updates and changes. The main thing is probably a newer Linux kernel. At the time of writing, it's 6.11. A newer version probably has more support and capabilities. Tuxedo has done some tweaks to the kernel and drivers. I think they have improved the NVIDIA support. They also use Pipewire, a newer audio manager that wasn't in Ubuntu 22, and took measures to make the playback smoother. I've had crackling sound on Linux, so this change interested me. I can see two Tuxedo tools that are pre-installed. One is a control center that displays hardware info and lets you choose between power profiles. This is meant for configuring Tuxedo computers. As I don't have one, this is not as useful for me, but I suppose it can be on the right hardware. The control center has a tray icon so you don't have to go searching for the app to configure. There is also Tuxedo Web FAI. As I understand, it is a web-based installer for Tuxedo OS running off of a USB drive as always. It can be made using the creator tool, which is apparently based on Balina Etcher. Of course, being based in Germany, the tool is also in German. For other applications, I haven't only slotted changes that come from Tuxedo repositories. It's mostly the things for running non-Linux stuff, Wine and VirtualBox. These are for attempting to run Windows programs and creating virtual machines respectively. For both of them, the latest stable version is packaged for Tuxedo and available in its repos. That is good, because these are really dependent on system software, and at this point I'm not really sure if I should download the 22.04 version. Wine had very questionable performance on previous Ubuntu versions. I remember having trouble running pretty much any game on Linux Mint 21. It's better on Tuxedo OS, but it's not the best I've seen. Just for an example, Game Maker gets stuck during loading or completely freezes. It's a step further than not starting at all, but it has worked for me on fully up-to-date distros like Fedora or even Debian testing. Tuxedo Edition for VirtualBox also has some bugs. First off, the sound doesn't work, I can't hear anything. There have been freezes and even crashes. Well, yes, I'm trying to run non-Linux software on Linux, so there might not be the greatest support, but it has been better on actually updated distros. Let's move on to the desktop and graphical interface. Tuxedo OS uses the latest Plasma desktop, which currently is 6.1.4. In fact, pretty much the entire KDE program suite is kept up to date. That's all great so far. The changes come from KDE Neon, a distro that has all the latest KDE applications on a Ubuntu LTS base. However, it's supposed to be for testing, and it's not the absolute best for personal use. I have run into bugs with the desktop before on that distro. Something that got carried on to Tuxedo OS is the desktop session tab in the settings. The values don't seem to be updated here, as you can see. No matter what the session restore to, it defaults to last logout. The biggest issue I have is that when shutting down or recovering from sleep under X11 graphics, it gets stuck on an empty screen with just a mouse cursor. Not much to do there. After looking it up, the solution is switched to Wayland, as it does not occur there. Updating the desktop during a restart instead of immediately while still on the desktop apparently helps, but it's not completely fixed on my end yet. Onwards with the appearance. Tuxedo OS has its own theme. I'm not a fan of it. It has like a reddish pink color, and the folder icons are mostly grey. What kind of distro taking itself seriously makes the interface pink? Fair enough if you approve it, but it's not for me. Fortunately, you can change the theme in the settings as always in KDE. Sure enough, the default ones are there. Tuxedo comes with a selection of its own wallpapers, along with the usual Plasma ones. However, sometimes the appearance settings cannot be accessed. It complains about an error opening XML files. After a few updates, I haven't run into that anymore, though I haven't had much reason to check the appearance settings after setting the theme. I remember the first time I tried to update or install the program, it took a really long time to not even install the program, but simply to get the list of available programs. After that first time, that ran fine, too. What's not as smooth about the visuals is that some programs don't use the right application style. You can see that I have selected the free style, but VLC and some others still use the Oxygen one, which makes it look a bit out of place. This next one is subjective, but I think Tuxedo Control Center takes away a bit of the system functionality. I'm a guy who prefers configuring stuff from the system settings, the panels and actual built-in apps. Here I have to configure profiles and parts of the display on a third-party tool. The distro being built on KDE Neon further delays the transition to the latest Ubuntu base of 24.04. You see, first Ubuntu has to make a bug fix release of 24.04.1, marking the distro as ready for upgrade. This was done at the end of August, less than a month ago. Now we have to wait for KDE Neon to adopt the new Ubuntu base and make a rolling system compatible with it, and otherwise get the distro to work. This is currently in progress with no schedule or end date revealed. And after that, Tuxedo OS still has to bring the Neon system to their distro, make it all work together, and do thorough testing on top of that. We will very likely get the next non-LTS release of Ubuntu before Tuxedo upgrades the distro to the LTS one. I thought we still had over a month for Ubuntu 24.10, but it will already be released in the first half of October. Let's take another look at the programs and compatibility. As Tuxedo OS is based on Ubuntu, it has a wide variety of programs available. Ubuntu repositories are packed, and if it doesn't have what you're looking for, the website of the program might have a Debian package available for the installation. If you're supposed to download the program off of a website and it's relatively well known, there's a chance it's packaged for you in Tuxedo repos and available with a simple apt install as usual. Some heavier programs have different packages for each Ubuntu version. The most logical option is to take the one made for 22.04. But considering the changes Tuxedo does to the system, I hope it works out. I tried installing VirtualBox from the website. It opened fine, but I don't think it fixed the issues. I repeat that programs from Ubuntu repositories are likely more than 2 years old and as such might not be up to standards. You can easily install updated flatpak apps. However, they take up more space and do not integrate with the system as well. For example, this does not respect the accent color. I've set it to this kind of green one, but Flatpak uses the default scheme of white with blue highlights. I tried Ubuntu 24.04 a bit after it was released, and an issue I had there was that there was an awful lot of crackling and stuttering audio. It seems like it's better on Tuxedo, but it still occurs on heavy workloads, especially when running apps through the compatibility layer and recording. How does gaming compare it? Well, I can't really tell. It seems to be similar to other general distros, though I have perhaps seen better performance. But don't take my word for it yet. So what are my current thoughts on Tuxedo OS? I like the idea behind it. Ubuntu base with an updated KDE Plasma desktop and performance improvements by a computer manufacturer. It is recommended online and I could see myself using it, but I'm somewhat discouraged by the system being largely old and the interface having some quirks. But what would be the alternatives for me? If I want to stay on the Ubuntu base, which would be nice, I could try Kubuntu again. Something I have gone back to and is still an alright option is Fedora, though it's maybe just a little more technical. I would like to find a distro to stick with and not distro hop as much, because with each switch, it takes time to set up the system, get the programs and bring my backed up files. So I'll see where I end up, and I guess that is all for this video. So perhaps leave a like and subscribe for more computer related videos, and I'll see you next time.